And then as we were about to leave, I had a little electric bulb in my head. And I said, say, Jim, I'm staying with a interesting chanteuse called Nico up in the hills. And I thought I would bring him up there and then he would fall in love with Nico. And then he would see the error of his ways in letting all these slimy little groupies, and he would never settle for a woman less beautiful or mystical or exotic than Nico. And since there weren't too many, then he would never have too many girlfriends, and my plot would be on its way. We finally got up to the house, and Nico was standing in a doorway, and he just looked at her, and she looked at him, and then they both cast their glances downward. And they stared at some imaginary spot on the floor in between them. And I tried to start a little chatteroony, and I saw this was going nowhere, that this was some kind of thing they were acting out. And I came back about an hour later, they were still in the exact same positions. They hadn't moved.
And they hadn't said anything?
They hadn't said anything. This is their way of acknowledging, you know, you're a beautiful, special, poetic person, I suppose. Edie was after, I had some pills with me. I always traveled with a little drug case then. I hid them somewhere under a bed and under a mattress and between two blankets and another mattress, and she got them. She found them, and she took about half of everything that was there. I don't know how she did. I don't know when she was in the room, but she did it. She was magical. She was having an affair with Dino Valenti. She wrote, come on, everybody, shine on your brother. Let's love one another. And the evening wore by, and the day wore by, and he and I went up to the room, and we started smoking a lot of hash. I started making a major speech to him about, I have these things in mind for you, and life is a roller coaster, and stardom is a trip, and I didn't know what I was doing. I was just sounding like every movie I had ever seen about, you know, what's in store, and play the game, and he would just open his palm about every 5 minutes and ask for another drug. Incredible amount of hash. About 6 hits of Orange Sunshine.
Nobody in those days got scared about, like, taking too much or dying.
I was scared. I thought he was gonna die. I had never seen. I mean, this was like enough drugs for me and everybody I met in like 2 weeks in California.
But you kept giving it to him.
And I kept giving to him. He wouldn't answer. And I would say, well, what do you think about that? Flight of brilliance, Jim. Got any more acid, man? In the middle of the night, David Newman came running into my room and said, oh my God, you have to see what's happening. And she was in the courtyard. She was crying and screaming, and he was naked on top of this house, and he was walking on it, like jumping over the gaps, totally naked. Jesus, what if he falls off? Am I gonna lose my job? That's all I could think of. Who cared about him? She came flying into my room and threw herself on the bed, and she was crying hysterically. You know, I never found out what had happened. I mean, he is so evil. Oh, he is so evil. And I'll make him calm down, go to bed. He's just stoned. I went to his car, and I took the keys out of the ignition and put them under floor mat. The next morning dawned, and he said, give me my car keys. And I said, no, you're in no condition to drive. And he was not smiling because it totally reversed everything that he stood for and everything that he tried to project. Nico and Edie suggested we go over to some friend of theirs' house who had a swimming pool. And we got to this house, he didn't have a bathing suit. So I went through this pile of bathing suits and I said, here, Jim, this looks like it will fit you. Put this on and then we will go swimming. Where's my car keys, man? I said, I will find him later, Jim. Put this on. Oh, that's when he took off his thing and he got naked and I saw his cock, which was very big.
What do you mean, very big?
It was long. It was like a salami. It was long. We all drove back to the house. We found that all the dining room chairs had been put on the table. And there was a still from Chelsea Girls on the back of it. It said, Jim, your ass is mud. Call us and get to rehearsal fast. I said, have you looked under the mat of your car? Perhaps you put the keys there, as so many people do. And he gave me a look like, oh, so that's where you hit him. And he got him, and he drove away. And he hated me from that point on. He was constantly trying to get Jack Holzman to fire me.
Why?
From Elektra Records. Well, because I had kidnapped him.
Jim got really pissed. And he called me, and he says, keep Danny Fields away from me. And I'm going to call Jack now.